I welcome you all for the power electronic course. So in this course, today we are going to see about the type E chopper. In the previous videos, I taught you about the type A, type B, type C, type D choppers. So where type A and B choppers are called one quadrant chopper, and type C and D choppers are called two quadrant choppers. Here the type E chopper is called four quadrant chopper. Okay, so how it works in four quadrant chopper, in four quadrants, that is, it is made up of two type C choppers, because type C chopper is a two quadrant chopper. So if you combine two type C choppers, you can get four quadrant chopper. Okay, so in that way we have combined two type C choppers together. Here we are going to use four switches, that is CH1, 2, 3 and 4, four switches and four diodes D1, D2, D3, D4. Okay, the load is of L and E type. Okay. We are going to consider here the output current. Okay, if the output current is in this direction, it is said to be positive, and if the output voltage with this polarity, that is plus this side and minus this side, okay, the output voltage with this polarity is said to be positive. So with this small introduction, let us enter into the operation, four quadrant operation. So this is the four quadrant, that is the class E chopper can be operated in all the four quadrants. In first quadrant, this is the first quadrant. In first quadrant, the output voltage and output current both are positive. So in this quadrant, switches 1 and 4 will be on, and switch 1, okay, that is CH1, will be operated. Okay, operated means when the switch 1 is on, what will happen, and when the switch 1 is off, what will happen. Okay, that we will see. In the second quadrant, output voltage is positive and output current is negative. Okay, in this quadrant, switch 2 will be on. Okay, when the switch 2 is on, what will happen, and when the switch 2 is off, what will happen. Okay, that is the CH2 switch is operated here in this second quadrant. In the third quadrant, the output voltage is negative, and the output current is also negative. Okay, both output voltage and output current are negative in this third quadrant operation. So in this quadrant, switches 2 and 3 are on, and the switch 3 is operated. So operated means when the switch 3 is on, what will happen, and when the switch 3 is off, what will happen. Okay, that we will see in the third quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, the voltage is negative, but the current is positive. Okay, so in this fourth quadrant, the output voltage is negative and the output current is positive. So in this quadrant, switch 4 will be operated. When the switch 4 is on, what will happen, when the switch is, when the switch 4 is off, what will happen, that we will see in the fourth quadrant operation. Okay, now we can explain the operation by using different modes. Okay, this is the first mode, so I will explain the first mode of operation. In this first mode, switches, okay, this is the first mode, switches 1 and 4 are on. That means this switch 1 and switch 4, okay, both the switches are on. Then what will be the current flow? So the current flows through the switch 1, inductor E, switch 4 and source. Okay, so this will be the current flow. So this time the current with the inductor will charge with this polarity, that is plus to minus. Okay, with this polarity it will charge. So the current direction is the output current direction is the same direction what we have considered. Okay, the same direction. So the output current is positive. What about the voltage? So this is, this plus will be appeared over here, and this minus will be appeared over here. So the output voltage is also the same what we have considered as positive. Okay, so this terminal is positive, this terminal is negative. So the output voltage is also positive. So in this mode, the output voltage and output current both are positive. Okay, so now let us switch off this switch 1. Okay, now we are going to switch off, turn off this switch 1. Now what happens? So the inductor, okay, the inductor which stored energy will be dissipating its energy now. So it will change its polarity like this. Here plus, this side plus, and this side minus. Okay, so it will discharge its current from minus to plus. So like this it will discharge in this loop. The diode D2 will conduct. Okay, so here also now the output current is positive because the output, the flow, current flow direction is same as we have considered. Okay, the same current flow direction. So the output current is positive and the output voltage is also with the same polarity. So the output voltage is also positive. So this is the first quadrant. In this quadrant, both the output voltage and output current are positive. Okay, when the switches, both the switches are on, what happened? The output voltage and output current are positive. When the switch 1 is off, okay, 1 is off, then this current flows through this slope and diode D2 conducts. So here also the output voltage and output current are positive. So it works in first quadrant. In first quadrant, that is CH1, CH4 are on. And CH4, D2 conducts. Okay, so how CH4 and D2 conducts? Okay, first when both the switches are on, CH1, CH4 on, and CH1 is operated. Okay, when the CH1 is off, then diode D2 and CH4 conducts. CH4 and diode D2 conducts. So in this quadrant, both the output voltage and output current are positive. Okay, so this is about the first quadrant operation. Now we can see the second quadrant operation. In this quadrant, what are the devices working? So this is the second quadrant. In this quadrant, switch 2, okay, switch 2 will be operated. That means now let us consider that this switch 2 is on. So what will happen? Now let us see the second mode of operation. In this mode, the switch is CH2. Will be operated. Okay, see here in this mode, switch 2. Okay, switch 2 is operated. So first we can switch on this switch 2. Then what will happen? This battery will deliver, will deliver its current. So the current flow will be like this. Okay, through the inductor, switch 2 and diode 4 and battery. Okay, this will be the current flow. So at this duration, this inductor will charge its energy with this polarity. So plus this side and minus this side. Okay, this inductor will charge its current. So the current output current direction is in the opposite direction what we have considered as positive. Okay, so the output current now it is in the negative direction, okay, in the opposite direction. So the output current is negative, whereas the output voltage is positive. Okay, the output voltage is the same what we have considered earlier with this polarity, plus this side and minus with this side. So the output voltage is positive, but the output current is negative. Okay, in the second mode. Now what will happen when the switch is off? When the switch is, when the switch 2 is off, the inductor is now going to release its energy. Okay, so it will discharge through, so it will discharge like this with this polarity, just plus over here, minus over here. So it will discharge from minus to plus, diode 1 source, and then D4 battery. Okay, so with this direction it will discharge. So now also the output current is negative, since both are in the opposite direction. Okay, this is output current is negative, but the output voltage, okay, output voltage is positive what we have considered. So this polarity will be here and this polarity will be here. So the output voltage is with the same polarity. So output voltage is positive. Okay. So when the switch is on, when the switch was on, the output current was positive and the output current was negative and the output voltage was positive. Now when the switch is off, okay, now the switch is off. So this time also the current output current is negative and the output voltage is positive. So this is the mode 2. So in this mode, the output voltage is positive and the output current is negative. So this is the second mode. The output voltage is positive and the output current is negative. In this, when the switch 2 is on, switch 2 and D4 conducts. Okay, when the switch was on, CH2, that is switch 2 and D4 were conducting. Now, then the switch is off. Okay, when this switch is off, diode D1 and D4 conduct. Okay, diode D1 and D4 conduct. This is the second mode of operation. Now we can see the third mode of operation. So in this mode, so what are the devices in the on condition? CH3 and CH2. So switch 3 and switch 2 are on. Okay, so this is the switch 3, it is on, and switch 2 is also on. Okay, this CH3 will be operated. So when this CH3 is on, what is the working, and when this CH3 is off, what is the working? Okay, now both the switches are on. Now what will happen? So this current flow will be like this: from the source, switch 3, battery, inductor, and then switch 2, then source. Okay, so the current flow will be like this. So in this duration, the current flow is like this. Okay, so here it goes. So the at this time the inductor will charge like with this polarity. Okay, plus to minus, because it comes through this. So plus to minus, the inductor charges like this. Okay, so what about the output current here? Output current is negative, because what we have considered, the direction, output current direction is this one, but here the output current direction is the opposite one. Okay, so the output current what we have is negative. What about the voltage? So this plus polarity will be here and this minus polarity will be here. So the output voltage is also negative. Okay, because the output voltage what we get now is the opposite to the polarity what we have considered already. Okay, so the output voltage is negative and the output current is also negative. So the third mode of operation, in this mode, when the switch is on, both the output current and output voltage are positive. Okay, now what will happen when the switch 3 is off? Okay, now we have turned off this switch. Now what will be the operation? So now it is off. Okay, now only the switch 2 is on. So what about the operation? Now it will discharge with this polarity. Okay, so minus to plus, so it will be discharging like this from inductor, CH2, D4, battery. Okay, so with this polarity it will discharge. So here also now the output current is negative. What about the voltage? So the voltage is negative. Okay, so in this mode, the third mode of operation, both the output voltage and output current both are negative. So what we have seen here is true, that is CH3 and CH2 are on. Okay, when CH3 is on, what happened? The output voltage and output current are negative, and the switch CH2 were on. When the CH3 is off, then CH2 and D4 conducts. Okay, so in this case also the output voltage and output current are positive. So this is the third mode of operation. Now we can see the fourth mode of operation. So in this mode, what are the devices in working condition? So in this mode, what are the devices in working condition? Diode D2 and D3. Okay, so D2 and D3 means okay, this one and this one. What switch is going to conduct? That is CH4. Okay, now CH4 will be operated. So when the switch 4 is on, what happens? Okay, when the switch 4 is on, what happens? The current will flow through the switch 4 diode, inductor and source. Okay, so this will be the current path. So here the current is positive. Okay, the output current is positive. What about the voltage? Voltage is negative. So here the positive terminal will come and here the minus terminal. Okay, so the output voltage is negative. In this fourth mode, the output voltage is negative and the output current is positive. So the output current is positive. Okay, output voltage is negative. Now what will happen when the switch is off? Now we have turned off this switch. Now it will release its energy with this polarity. Okay, so minus to plus. So it will release from inductor, battery, D3, source, and then D2, inductor. Okay, so now also the output current is positive. But what about the output voltage? So this plus will be appeared over here and this minus will be appeared over here. So this polarity is opposite to the polarity what we have considered. The output current is same as we have considered. So the output current is positive and the output voltage is negative. Okay, this is the fourth mode of operation. In the fourth mode, the output current is positive and the output voltage is negative. Okay, so in this duration, the switch CH4 is operated. That is, when the switch 4 is on, the current flows through CH4 and D2. When the CH4 is off, the diodes D2 and D3 conduct. Okay, this is the fourth mode of operation. So since the chopper E, okay, that is type E chopper, is operated in all these four quadrants, it is called four quadrant chopper. Now we will see what are the effects of source and load inductance. Okay, so already we have seen about this source inductance in the second unit, in the case of controlled rectifier. Okay, so here also we can see what are the effects of source and load inductance. So the source inductance should be small, okay, as small as possible to limit the transient voltage. Okay, to limit this transient voltage, we have to keep this source inductance as small value. Then also the source inductance may cause commutation problem. So already we have seen, okay, that is commutation angle, otherwise the overlap angle, we have seen about it. Okay, so that is the problem because of this source inductance. To improve this commutation problem, okay, otherwise to overcome this source inductance problem, we have to use an input filter. Okay, that is a filter should be used in the input side of the circuit. Then the load ripple current is inversely proportional to the load inductance and chopping frequency. Okay, so the load current, peak load current, depends on the load inductance. So to overcome this load ripple, okay, ripple current, we can use a inductor. Okay, so smoothing inductor, if we use it, will filter out the load ripple currents. Okay, so these are the effects of source and load inductance. So in this type E chopper, we have seen why it is classified according to the output voltage and output current. Okay, in the all the four, because it works in all the four quadrants. Okay, in the, all the four quadrants, what about the output voltage and output current we saw? Then we have seen about the effects of source and load inductance. Okay, so that's all about type E chopper. Thank you.